Wow, good to have you back to my channel. I'm glad you are here. In this video, we'll be looking at PC components part 3. In our subsequent video, we looked at various PC components like input devices, output devices, processing devices. But in this video, we'll be looking at storage devices. But before then, it's important that we look at why we need to back up our data, our files. So in this lesson objective, we're looking at backing storage and why we need to back up our data. So somebody might want to ask, why do we need to back up our data? Is it necessary for us to back up our data? Why must we do it? So what do we tend to achieve by backing up our data? Or what's the goal, or what's the rationale behind data backing up? Now, it's interesting to know that when we talk about backing up, we are talking about copying our file or data to a different location should in case the primary storage is faulty. You know, the truth is, as we proceed in life, we can't tell what will happen tomorrow. It's possible that a company system can be engulfed with fire. It's possible that the company system can fall down and damage. It's possible that the company system can be corrupted with a virus. So, by copying our file to a different location, we are much assured or more secured of having our files intact in different locations. So, should in case the main memory or the main storage is faulty or is corrupt. So, backing up is seen as a good practice in computing. So, it's advisable for you and I to back up our files on a daily basis. These days, we have automatic backing up where we set our computer to back up our files on a daily basis or timely. You know, these days, for example, in our WhatsApp we use, now, WhatsApp, we try to back up our WhatsApp file, we set a time, back up every 1 hour, back up every 10 hours, back up every day, back up once a week, back up once in a month. So, regular backing up is seen as a good computing practice. Now, let's move on why we need to back up. So, should in case there is a fire outage or situation that could lead to irreversible or irretrievable loss of important files, backup helps us to see have our data intact without panicking. So, we backup to safeguard against loss of data or loss of files due to failures of the primary storage where the main files are. And these failures are in different dimensions. For example, our hardware component can fail. I've seen a case whereby a hard disk component crash. So if your hard disk crash, if you have a backup, it's easier for you to retrieve your file from that different location and continue a smooth running of your daily activity. It's also possible that you are trying to save a file and unknown to you, you accidentally rename an existing file with a new file while the old file is still important to you. So it's possible that you overwrite an existing file, but assuming we have a backup of that previous file in a different location, we can easily retrieve that data without panic. Another possible reason why we secure our data of other possible kind of flaws that can happen is possible corruption of files. For example, now hackers might try to introduce into your system by manipulating into your system. By so doing, those data can be corrupted. Sometimes they introduce Trojan horse, which is a virus that tends to corrupt your file. But assuming you have a backup, it's very easy for us to rescan our system, put in a state rightful state, then copy our files back again from the external storage where we back up the file to our main memory. By so doing, it will be an itch-free run of daily activities. But when there is no backup, we are bound to have challenges in smooth running of our organization. Another reason again is that we, like I said, is that we try to back up to safeguard our files against hackers. You know, these days, hackers don't rest. All they try to do is to penetrate into company systems, institutional systems. These days, we have what we call cyber security, because cyber attack is on the increase. So, but when we are, we have backups our file, so these backups make us to retrieve our files or helps us to have our original files intact against possible loss or corruption that may be that may have resulted from hackers coming to your system. So should in case you want to learn more, please stay tuned, subscribe to our channel. Thank you for listening.